Gentlemen, we are now on our day two, not far from Cape Town, about 300 kilometers more or less. We are here at the roadworks drive stop, so we're standing still in the road. They will open up for us in a minute or two. This is now what they call the Great Karoo. Yesterday we did that the small Karoo, and this is the last part of the desert area. We will in a more or less an hour be at the nice areas between the mountains and valleys and all the vineyards. So while I'm stopping, I thought I will just say morning and for day two. We are here in Lanesburg, and we come upon this old fort and two another cars. I'll show you now. This is an old fort. And this one is a Patterson, and according to the number plate, it comes from Pretoria area where I was coming from. New cars. And this one is a towel boat. First time I hear about a car like this one. Gentlemen, I want to show you. You see this little button board there? It indicates flood level. It was a couple of years ago, this town was underwater due to a flood. The river that runs next to the town overflow up to this height. Just the truck pass. So the whole town was underwater. That was the flood level. So you can see higher than the cars that pass here. This is a Western Cape old town. Okay, just want to show you that interesting piece of history. Yes, here we are entering now the nice part of the Western Cape. This is the first, one of the first passes. It's called the Hex River Pass. Gents, this is a nice pass. Right down on the right hand side, far below, is the other side of the road. You can see the truck there coming up. And the nice mountain there in front. Let's see what is around the corner. One of the great valleys where they grow grapefruit. Very, very beautiful. There's some more nice places. This is just the beginning. There's a tunnel in front, can you see? If you zoom a little bit, I think we're gonna go, that's the old tunnel, we're gonna pass it on the right hand side as far as I know. Just a little bit of landscape here. this is a nice view here on a very close to the vineyards, communities that grow the grapes, and here on the left hand side as well. Gents, what you see there is the workers that work in the vineyards for the farmers. They're all staying here in this area. Every house have the electricity, everything. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, just let nature do the talking. Just sit back and enjoy. Gents, we are now in the Tourist Kloof Pass. Just look at the nice mountains. And so just enjoy the nice road. So I'm not going to talk much. I believe the whole about a kilometer or two will be very good. But just enjoy. Okay. Gents, here we enter the tunnel. We'll see how long it is. That was cool. It was about 2 kilometers long, I believe. I will check up. Really nice. Want to show you something. See the mountain. You see that two mountain tops there? They call it the pole, like in pole. So this area that you see the town is called the pole. And then on the left hand side there's a monument. That's our Afrikaans language monument. Hopefully you can see it. And here is a toll gate. I'll say, Jenny's, we reached our destination at the sea. That part is called Gordon's Bay and all the strand. And another name is Somerset West. So we're gonna go to the seashore now and take a couple of videos there. But there is eventually made our way down to Cape Town. Cape Town is on the right eventually. Thanks for the journey so far. Here we are on the beach. At the point there, at that mountain, there's a place called Gordon's Bay, which have a nice harbor. And I want to show you Table Mountain, a very famous Table Mountain, but it's from the backside, sort of. So if you look in the distance there, hopefully you can see it's very foggy. But the mountain that you see there is it's Table Mountain, but that familiar look is now from the west, and we're standing now from the east. So that's why you would not recognize it. But this is Table Mountain. So we made it. All the people. Very cool.